Stryker is a family of eight-wheel drive combat vehicles built for the U.S. Army by General Dynamics Land Systems Canada and the General Dynamics Land System Division USA. It is based on the General Dynamics Land Systems Canada LAV III 8x8 light armored vehicle in service since early 2001. The LAV III is itself a version of the Piranha III built by Mowag of Switzerland, now part of General Dynamics Land Systems Europe. In this video, we are going to take a closer look at the Stryker family and its many different configurations. Before we get started, if you do enjoy this video and would like to see more just like it, remember to give us a like and subscribe to our channel to get more sent straight to your notifications. On February 27, 2002, the U.S. Army named its new interim armored vehicle the Stryker in a ceremony at Fort Lauderdale. The Stryker is a highly deployable wheeled armored vehicle that combines firepower, battlefield mobility, survivability, and versatility with reduced logistics requirements. The vehicle was named in honor of two Medal of Honor recipients, Private First Class Stuart S. Stryker, who died in World War II, and Specialist 4 Robert F. Stryker, who died in the Vietnam War. At the time of its introduction, the Stryker M1126 was considered as an interim vehicle until more advanced future designs would become available. A contract was signed with General Dynamics Land Systems for 2,131 Stryker vehicles of all variants to equip six Rapid Deployment Brigade combat teams. The first operational vehicles were delivered to the U.S. Army in 2003. Deliveries were completed in 2014. A total of 4,466 Strykers were delivered to the U.S. Army. These vehicles currently equip 9 Stryker brigades. The Stryker is better protected than many other armored personnel carriers, including Russian and Chinese designs. The basic hard steel armor is augmented by applique panels of lightweight ceramic and composite armor, produced by a team led by Diesenroth Engineering of Germany. Its front arc is designed to withstand hits from 14.5mm heavy machine gun rounds. All-around protection is against 7.62mm NATO ball rounds. A ceramic add-on armor can be fitted to give all-around protection against 14.5mm armor-piercing rounds. The interior of the vehicle is lined to protect crew and passengers from spalling. In July 2010, General Dynamics Land Systems was awarded a $30 million contract for the production of a dual V-shaped hull for the Stryker Infantry Combat Vehicle. And in 2018, the U.S. Army awarded a contract modification worth $258 million to conduct the upgrade of 116 Stryker vehicles to the A1 configuration. With a further $383 million, they were able to upgrade another 173 vehicles. This vehicle can sustain speeds of over 60 miles per hour, with a range exceeding 300 miles on 53 gallons of fuel, have parts commonality and self-recovery abilities, and also has a central tire inflation system. The infantry carrier vehicle carries a 9-man infantry squad and a crew of 2. It has a remote weapon station with a M2 50 caliber machine gun, MK19 40mm grenade launcher, or MK240 7.62mm machine gun. It is also armed with 4 M6 smoke grenade launchers. The remote weapon station includes a thermal imaging camera, and the vehicle's commander has an FB-CB2 digital communication system that allows communication between vehicles through text messaging and a map network, as well as with the battalion. The map shows the position of all vehicles on the battlefield, and the commander can mark the position of enemy forces on the map, which can then be seen by other commanders. The Stryker driver has 3 M17 periscopes and a DRS Technologies ANVAS-5 driver's vision enhancer. The vehicle commander also has 7 M45 periscopes and a thermal imager display with video camera. In 2009, a Check 6 thermal imaging driver's rear view camera system was fitted to the vehicle's taillight housing. The Stryker interim armored vehicle is a 19-ton, full-time 4-wheel drive, selectively 8-wheel drive vehicle that provides the Army a family of 10 different vehicles on a common chassis. The Stryker comprises 2 variants, the infantry carrier vehicle and the mobile gun system. The infantry carrier vehicle has 8 additional configurations, including the M1129 mortar carrier, M1127 reconnaissance vehicle, M1130 commander's vehicle, M1131 fire support vehicle, M1133 medical evacuation vehicle, M1132 engineer squad vehicle, M1134 anti-tank guided missile vehicle, and the M1135 nuclear, biological, and chemical reconnaissance vehicle. The reconnaissance vehicle is fitted with the Raytheon long-range advanced surveillance system. The system includes a second-generation horizontal technology initiative thermal imager, DATV, and iSafe laser rangefinder. The U.S. Army is to enhance the system by lengthening the sensor mast to 10 meters, increasing the range to 10 kilometers. The mortar carrier entered service in August of 2005. Its 120mm mortar is mounted inside the vehicle and fires through doors that swing open at the top of the vehicle. As well as the mounted mortar, the vehicle carries a second mortar, which has to be unloaded before firing. The vehicle has a digital fire control system and a crew of 5. The first of 17 nuclear, biological, and chemical reconnaissance vehicle variants was delivered in December of 2005. The system can collect and automatically integrate contamination information with vehicle navigation and meteorological sensor data, and then transmit digital warning messages to other forces. The U.S. Army placed a contract for 33 medical evacuation vehicles in September of 2007. These vehicles can accommodate up to 6 patients and a medical team. The commander's vehicle provides commanders with communication, data, and control functions to analyze and prepare information for combat missions. It can also link to aircraft antennas for planning missions while en route aboard aircraft. They are deployed as 3 vehicles per brigade. The engineer squad vehicle, with its attachment, provides a partial solution to the obstacle clearance role, primarily for the clearance of hastily emplaced mines on hard surfaces and rubble. Plus, will enable the engineer squad to control future robotic-based systems. The Stryker mobile gun system variant consists of the basic vehicle with the General Dynamics Land Systems fully stabilized, shoot-on-the-move, low-profile turret. The turret is armed with an M68A1E4 105mm cannon with muzzle brake and an M2 50 caliber commander's machine gun. The Stryker mobile gun system can fire 18 rounds of 105mm main gun ammunition, 400 rounds of 50 caliber ammunition, and 3,400 rounds of 7.62mm ammunition. Curtis Wright Corps Vista Controls supplies the fully automated ammunition loading and replenishing system. 2 M6 smoke grenade launchers are also fitted. The mobile gun system has the same C4ISR communications and driver's vision equipment as the infantry carrier vehicle, but the gunner has 3 periscopes and a compact modular sight with dual field of view day and thermal channels. It also has detectors for nuclear, biological, and chemical weapons. An advantage to the brigade combat teams in having the mobile gun vehicle of the same Stryker family of vehicles is the commonality across the entire capability and the reduced logistics requirement. The Stryker can be transported on the ground using trucks or by air on C-17, C-5, and C-130 aircraft. The C-5 can carry 7 Strykers, and the C-17 carries 4. The C-130H can fly safely, carrying a maximum 38,000-pound load for up to 1,000 nautical miles. The Stryker's weight, 36,240 pounds, and size are within the payload limit of the C-130H. The C-130 can operate from smaller airfields in more remote locations. All configurations of the Stryker can disembark from the C-130 in combat-ready status. In response to poor performance against IEDs, the Army began manufacturing and retrofitting Stryker vehicles with a more survivable double V-hull designed underside. 7 Stryker versions are being produced in this configuration, which sequentially includes the M1251, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, and the M1257. However, 3 variants, the M1127, 28, and 35, are not receiving the new hull and will retain their current flat bottom. While the mobile gun system gives medium brigades heavy firepower, the baseline infantry carrier vehicle has a light armament. So the idea of equipping the infantry carrier vehicle with 30mm cannons came about. The U.S. Army awarded a contract to Oshkosh Defense in June 2021 to build the medium caliber weapon system, a 30mm unmanned turreted autocannon on a Stryker combat vehicle. The first delivery order, valued at about $130 million, covers 91 vehicles. In August, the Army ordered 83 more in a deal worth $99 million. The first unit to receive the medium caliber weapon system Strykers will be the 1-2 Stryker Brigade Combat Team out of Joint Base Lewis-McChord in Washington State. The Army expects to complete fielding that unit by December 2023. The service opted to outfit 3 out of 6 brigades equipped with double V-Hull A1 Strykers with 30mm guns, following an Army Requirements Oversight Council that reviewed the performance of a rapidly fielded 30mm Stryker Dragoon system urgently built to support the 2nd Cavalry Regiment in Europe. What do you think of the Stryker family of vehicles? Are there any other feats of engineering you'd like to see us cover? Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give us a like and subscribe to our channel to get our latest videos straight to your notifications. Thanks for watching.